KimTV.com, man. First, I'd like to say congratulations, because if you're watching this video, that means you have purchased my TikTok course. What I'm going to do is show you step-by-step directions how to get your first 1K and start generating money in the same day. So let's get going, get right into it. This is from beginning to end. If you don't know nothing about TikTok, if you're a beginner, if you're mediocre, if you already got an account, I got everybody covered. So if you're the first person and you never had an account, I'm going to show you step-by-step on how to get one. So the first thing I would do is I would go to the Play Store. If I got an Android, if I got an iPhone, I'll go to the App Store. And I go search the App Store and search for TikTok and make sure it's downloaded and installed on my phone. So I put in TikTok, it pop up, and I'll make sure that it's downloaded. I will click open, and then I will click sign up. I don't have an account. I just tried to log in just now with this new phone that I got, and an account already popped up under my number. So I deleted it, and I'm gonna try to see if it work again. So I'm gonna use my phone or my email, and I'm gonna see if this worked this time. So I deleted it. Let's see if we can start all over. The number is 309. So I just sent myself the code. You can log in any way you want to log in. You can log in with your email, your Facebook, Apple emails, whatever email you got, you can log in like that. So I'm gonna just do something else then, because it's finna blow me. I'm gonna continue with Apple. That's what I'm gonna pick. Got my name, my iCloud, and everything, so I'm gonna continue with it. So I got my Face ID on. So now it's gonna ask you for your birthday. I just use my Apple iCloud because I'm getting frustrated. I try to use my new cell phone, which looks like somebody else had this account, which I'm not even tripping. But let's get it. My birthday is April. We're gonna say April 3rd, 1994. That's my birthday. Click next. Create a nickname. When you create your username, make sure you pick something unique. That's unique for you, unique for your brand. Something that's easy to remember. Something that your fans and your followers can actually think about. So you might need to sit down and take some time to really think about what name you really, really, really want. So I'm gonna create me a nickname, Keelan Course. I don't know how to spell course. I'm gonna press confirm. They're gonna ask you to find your contacts. You can, if you want. If you got a lot of phone numbers and you got a lot of friends, you can use that to find your contacts. If not, you don't have to. I'm gonna click don't allow. Now I'm gonna go to my profile, and it's ready for me to start designing and creating. So the first thing I will do is I will pick a picture to put on my profile. So try to pick something nice. So first thing we're gonna do is click edit profile. Now you can change your profile. You add a picture. Take one, upload, whatever one. I'm going to just say upload. And I'm going to put a picture of me with my art up there. And I'm going to click save and post. Then now you can just give yourself a short bio. Describe your page, what you bring to the table. And so I'm going to put artist. Because I love to do art. Content creator, because I love to create content. It's 80 characters, so be creative with it. So try to come up with something where people can come on your page and know exactly what you do. All right, I'm an artist, and I create content, and I paint. So people going to know that when they come on my page, I'm an artist, I create content, and I love to paint. So I'm going to save that. Next, you can add pronouns if you want. You already did the bio. Non-for-profit. You can also add your links. So it'd be pretty cool to add like your Instagram or your YouTube or something. So when people want to follow you on other platforms, they can follow you on other platforms. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and next thing I'm going to do is show you how to upload your first piece of content. Again, if you already got all this already taken care of, you can skip to the next part of the keep going. So what I will do is I will click upload, and I'm going to just say I'm upload this picture of me flying in the air, and I'm going to click next. So
consistency, man. That's
as you see
the game,
is
bro.
The music playing.
You keep going every-
I'm gonna turn the music off, but TikTok give you so many options to actually go crazy in editing, from adding music, captions, effects, anything. So what I can do is I can add whatever song I want to add. I can search for a specific song, like there's a lot of copyright issues, so it might, some stuff might pop up, some stuff might not. So I'll put in Lil Wayne, see if that pop up. See what pop up. And Ashley and Millie pop up. She Will, How to Love. So I got a lot of options to pick from. Lollipop, Can't Be Broken. I didn't even know this music was on here. And it even got some videos, look like. So I'm going to put a Millie. So I got a Millie to my picture. And then I can put, I'm gonna turn it down real quick so y'all can hear me. I'm gonna put some title with it. I'm gonna put Flying High. Or some type of caption, Flying High. So now I just made my first post with the Millie song, and I just put a caption, and then next thing I'm gonna press next. It's way more awesome. I can put filters on it. I can put videos up here. I can do whatever I want. I can play with it, but I'm gonna just click next. Next, you want to add some type of description so people can find you. So I'm going to put Flying High. And then use hashtags and stuff. You can tag people in it. So I'll put hashtag first TikTok. My first TikTok. First TikTok. Hashtag Lil Wings. I put his music. And I will put hashtag FYP, the For You page. So I got my first post up. I can add a link if I want to. I can change my privacy settings if I want to. I can change it to only me can see it. I can only be only my friends, or I can make it for everyone that's in the world. I also can share it to Facebook and all other social media sites. They give you an option for more options where I can allow people to make a stitch, a duet. I can tell them if this was AI generated. I can even save it to my device. So they got the option where when you make a TikTok video, it automatically saves to your device. So next, I don't need none of them options right now. So I just click post. So I got my first TikTok up right now, and it's a picture of me flying in the air. Next, what I will do is I will go search for some stuff that I like. So I'll go search for dancing and see what pop up, and I'll follow a couple of dancing accounts so TikTok can know I want to see dancing. Then I'll put in cooking. Unless you know specifically what people you're looking for. I put in cooking TikTok. Now a lot of cooking reels will pop up. I can follow a couple of people like them. So the plus sign is to follow them. You can hit the heart to like it. Right up under the heart, you can comment. or you can read the comments and you can leave a comment. This right here up under the comment is to add to your favorite, and right up under the add to your favorite is the share button where you can share it to other platforms. Right up under where you share it, it's an option to use that sound. So this person won't let me use this sound in this country, which I've never seen before. This is the first time I've ever seen that. So I'm going to try to find something else and try to give you an example. So if I hit the last one at the bottom, it's the circle, and I can add that specific sound to my favorites. I can use it for later, or I can use it right now. So that's just some couple of options you can do. So that's pretty much setting up your TikTok page. You got it step by step, how to set up your page. And you got your first post up, you got your bio up, you got you a nice picture up, you got you a nice catching TikTok name, and you ready to build your brand. Let's get it.